Hello students, in this video lecture we will discuss about the multi-stage compression for reciprocating type of air compressor. As we know that compressors are used to pre-compress the air up to a higher value, but if it is done in a single stage or in a single cylinder, it will require a large cylinder size, as well as it will increase the delivery temperature. So to overcome such problems, we use the multi-stage compression. It means the compression of the air done is different stages. Air will be compressed first in first stage, then in the second stage, then the third stage, passing through in between to the intercooler to cool the air to decrease the temperature. So for a given value of the certain volume, if we are increasing RP, which is the pressure ratio, it will decrease volumetric efficiency. Second negative point is that it will increase the delivery temperature. It is given by the relation T2 equal to T1 P2 by P1 to the power n minus 1 upon n. So by increasing this pressure ratio P2 by P1, it will increase the delivery temperature. Now to achieve high pressure while avoiding those problems, we have to use multi-stage compression. So here from this PV diagram, what we are seeing is that there are the three cycles A, B, C and D, and this cycle is being used if we have to increase the pressure from P1 to P2. Now if we have to increase the pressure more up to the pressure P3, then we have to follow the cycle from A, B dash, C dash to D dash, and for achieving the pressure P4, we have to follow the cycle A, B double dash, C double dash and D double dash. It is also showing the clearance volume VC as well as the swept volume VS. So at some intermediate pressure PI, the air is sent to a smaller cylinder to be compressed further. Now in this multi-stage type of compression, we are seeing this diagram is showing for the two-stage type of compression. So in the first stage, the cycle is from A, B, C and D. The air is compressed from the pressure P1 to the intermediate pressure PI. This is the intermediate pressure PI. Then after this first stage, here the compression is followed, which is given by the relation PV to power n equal to constant, the polytropic compression. Here T double dash A is equal to TB, because the air is cooled up to the initial pressure, initial temperature in the intercooler. Then in the second stage, the compression is done from the point A double dash to B double dash and C dash to D dash. So it is also the polytropic compression. So stage 1 and stage 2 both are being seen here. Now from this diagram, we are seeing this shaded area, and this shaded area indicates about the effect of intercooling, and this area says that this amount of work input is saved if we are following the multi-stage type of compression. So from the schematic diagram here given, the air at the pressure P1 and temperature T1 will enter the first stage or the LP cylinder ABCD, which is ABCD. Then the air will be compressed here, and after compression the air will pass through the intercooler. Here we are using the water jacket or water will come, enter the intercooler, will take heat from the air and will go out. So it is cooling the air at a temperature. Then after reducing its temperature, this air will enter in the second stage. In the second stage, it is shown by A double dash, B double dash, C double dash, D dash. And after passing it, there is also cooled in the after cooler. Now in the multi-stage type of compression, we are seeing that from the TS diagram, it is showing that pressures, pressure P1, then pressure PI and pressure P2. So P1 is the initial pressure of the air which enters the first stage cylinder, then PI is the intermediate pressure and P2 is the pressure at the delivery. So you can see here from this point to this, that there is the compression in the first stage or the LP cylinder. Then after achieving this pressure PI, it is cooled from temperature T2 to T1 and then it is entered in the higher or the second stage and being compressed up to this temperature T2 and the pressure P2, then it is further cooled in the after cooler. So complete the intercooling. If intermediate temperature TI is cooled back to the same temperature as T1, so it is being seen here that temperature from T1 to T2, but this temperature is being cooled and TI, which is the intermediate temperature, is same as the temperature of T1. Now optimum intermediate pressure. So to obtain the optimum intermediate pressure, we have to select a pressure PI, which is the intermediate pressure, and it affects the amount of compression work that has to be supplied. Now an optimum value of the PI will give us the minimum compression work. So let's assume the complete intercooling for this system or for this multi-stage compression. Then the total work input required is equal to work done for the low stage plus work done for the high stage. Then this will be equal to n by n minus 1 mRT1 PI by P1 whole to the power n minus 1 upon n minus 1. It is for the low stage, and for the higher stage n by n minus 1 mRTI P2 upon PI. Here the pressure ratio is P2 by PI to the power n minus 1 upon n minus 1. Since here TI is equal to T1, then we can say double quote equal to n upon n minus 1 mRT1 equal to PI by P1 to the power n minus 1 upon n plus P2 by PI n minus 1 upon n minus 2. Next, the optimum intermediate pressure. So for a fixed value of the P1, temperature T1 and P2, we can optimize the total or the minimum work required for the optimum value of intermediate pressure. So it can be obtained by differentiating this W total with respect to intermediate pressure and equating it to zero. So this dW total by dPI is equal to dy dPI n upon n minus 1 mRT1 PI upon P1 whole to the power n minus 1 upon n plus P2 by PI n minus 1 upon n minus 2, that is equal to 0. So it is dy dPI PI by P1 plus P2 by PI whole to the power n minus 1 upon n minus 2 equal to 0. Now on solving this, it gives PI square equal to P2 into P1 and PI by P1 equal to P2 by PI, or RP optimum obtained is P2 by P1 to the power 1/2 or square root of P2 by P1, and this PI optimum can be written as square root of P2 into P1. So optimum intermediate pressure for this case, for minimum compressor work and for the complete intercooling, as well as the same pressure ratio for all stages. We are considering here the same pressure ratio for the all stages. This can be generalized to more than two stages. W total is equal to n upon n minus 1 mRT1 PI by P1 whole to the power n minus 1 upon n minus 1 plus n upon n minus 1 mRTI P2 by PI whole to the power n minus 1 upon n minus 1, and this W total equal to 2n by n minus 1 mRT1 PI by P1 whole to the power n minus 1 upon n minus 1, and W total equal to 2n by n minus 1 mRT1 P2 by P1 to the power n minus 1 upon 2n.